Hello students, myself Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to deal with the topic design of flywheel. The learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to derive a formula which will be useful for deciding the dimensions of the flywheel. Now, in case of the earlier, we have seen that the flywheel, it consists of the outer part, it is the rim, and then at the center we are having the hub, which is having the hole, and then the hub and the rim, these are connected with each other with the help of the spokes or the arms. Now, in case of the flywheel, so the mass moment of inertia, it is required, and now in case of the rim, as it is placed on the outer side, the contribution of the rim to the energy storage, it is more. So in case of this one, so here in case of this diagram, we have only shown the rim. So this part, it is rim. So from here to here it is, and now the rim, it is having thickness equal to T. Now let us first define the different parameters, and then we will go for the formula which we are going to make use for the determining the dimensions of the flywheel. Now for a flywheel, let R is equal to mean radius of flywheel. Then we will have A is equal to cross section area of rim, B is equal to width of rim, T is equal to thickness of rim. Now here we observe that cross section area of the rim, it is A, so it is going to be perpendicular to this one, the perpendicular to this plane we are going to observe that one. So here in this plane the thickness will be seen, thickness of the rim, and perpendicular to this one we are going to observe the depth of the rim, and then we are going to have the depth, it is nothing but it is the width of the rim. And in case of the area, cross section area of the rim, so we are going to get this one as it is nothing but it is B into it is T is there. Now next to that one we are going to have, say, omega is equal to angular velocity, then we are going to have, say, it is sigma is equal to tensile stress, then we will have rho as equal to it is density of material. Then we are going to have now the consideration of one element. Suppose this hatched portion, it is now the element, and now it is, this element is lying at an angular position of theta from the xx line, which is horizontal here. So the element, it is making an angle equal to, it is d theta, say it is this angle. Now next to that one we are going to have the CJ of this particular element, and then the centrifugal force, it is acting on this particular element. Now as the element, it is smaller, let df be equal to, it is centrifugal force on element, dm is equal to mass of element. Now from the formula of the centrifugal force, we are knowing that df is equal to mass, it is dm, it is mr omega square, it is mass into radii of rotation into it is angular velocity square. But dm is equal to, that is the mass of the element is equal to, so we are going to have volume into density. So in case of volume, again it is area of cross section into the width into density. Again we are going to have the cross section area as A it is. Now in case of this, the cross section area here in this view it will not be seen, so it is now this area is only seen as a line here. So when we are going to have the rotation of this area, that is this one, about the center, we are going to get the volume generated with the help of this area. So now the area has to be moved. So this area, which is seen as a line, it is to be moved from this particular point to this particular point, and during that one it is covering this small arc. It is now this arc, it is having radius equal to it is r, and it is subtending an angle equal to it is d theta. So in case of that one, we are going to have the width of this one, it is now it will be equal to r into it is d theta into the density we are having, it is equal to rho. So this one is now is equal to, it is df is equal to, so it is area into the width, here we are observing width of this particular element, so it is r into it is d theta, then it is rho into the remaining part we will have, it is r, and then it is omega square. So here we can observe that here r it is appearing twice, so this one will be equal to, so this df is equal to a into it is r square, then we will take omega square here, and then we are going to have the density, and then it is d theta. Now here in case of this centrifugal force, the components of this centrifugal force we can take, which is one is horizontal and the second one it is vertical. So it is making this df, it is making an angle equal to it is d theta with the horizontal. So the front side of this one, that is the vertical component, it is going to be df, it is sin theta. So vertical component of df is equal to a r square, omega d theta into it is sin theta. Now total vertical force is equal to, so now we have to go for the integration of this element. Now we are going to have this a r square, this omega square, rho into the integration sign, it is sin theta and it is d theta. Now we have to put the limits to the integration. So we have to think of, say, what should be the lower limit of the integration and on the upper side what we have to put here. You can think of 0, then it is 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi, or 0 to 2 pi, or it is, say, even not starting with 0, it is starting from pi, etc. So we are interested in the total vertical force, where it is going to have only vertical upward sign it is. See here, from here to here, if we are moving for this upper portion above x, we are going to get the vertical upward direction here. If the element it comes into this particular portion, the vertical downward force will be there. So we are going to put the values as 0 to it is pi, and this total vertical force, this will be equal to it is a r square, it is omega square rho into, we are going to have it is minus cos theta, then it is 0 to pi. So if we are solving this one, we will get this one as 2 a r square omega square is rho. Now the resisting force is equal to, so here it is resisting force is equal to, so resistance will be provided by the material, and here at two positions we are going to have, so the tensile stress or hoop stress will be there, and at two positions, so it is 2 into the P, it is there, so this will be nothing but it is equal to 2 into that sigma, which is say tensile stress or the hoop stress into the cross section area. So this one it is number 2, and this one it is equation number 1. So equating 1 and 2, we are getting this one as 2a r square omega square rho is equal to, it is 2 sigma into it is a, 2 will get cancelled and these will get cancelled. So we are going to have this one as a r square omega square is equal to sigma, but r omega we are knowing that it is linear velocity, it is v square is equal to sigma upon a, it has been cancelled here, and it is rho, and say it is rho into it is r square omega square, v square is equal to sigma upon rho, v is equal to it is under root sigma upon it is rho. So v is equal to, also it is pi d n upon it is 60. From this one the diameter can be determined, so diameter we are able to determine. Next, these are the references which are used. Thank you.